So today I've called into the Donnington Manor Hotel near Sevenoaks, and I thought I'd make this little video just to explain the charging situation here, if there's anyone coming here to charge their Tesla or staying in the hotel. There's a big Tesla sign there, which is very handy. I wish more places had that. So this place does have a camera and parking fees. So like that car there, if you pull in and stop, you're going to get charged. But Tesla vehicles, you don't need to pay, but you do need to go to reception and enter your number plate on the screen. But there's plenty of signage here to explain the situation, which is good to see. So the reception's just in there, with a bar to the left-hand side, and there's a screen in reception and in the bar where you can put your registration in the screen. And you can get a coffee, and you get 10% off if you're charging your Tesla. And then out the back here is the car park. So if you're an overnight guest at this hotel, there is a Podpoint charger here with 2 7-kilowatt AC charging points and all the information up there on the sign. And the Tesla Superchargers are at the back here. There are 8 version 3 250 kilowatt chargers there. And 3 Teslas, that one's just pulling in of course, but 3 out of 8, including me, being used at the moment. But yeah, looking around this car park, there's signage up there, there's signage up there. There's another one here. So yeah, very well done, even though you'd have to pay £1.50 if you don't go in and use the screen and put your reg in. Plenty of signage around telling you what the parking situation is. Oh, there's even more over there. 2 more signs there. There's another one there in the corner. Yes, very well done. There's also these signs scattered around showing you that you can get a coffee and cake from the bar, and you get 10% discount if you're charging your Tesla. And in each one of these 8 Tesla charging bays is a full set of signage telling you exactly what you've got to do. So there is no doubt, which is absolutely brilliant. So I bought a latte. It was £3.85 with the 10% discount for Teslas. It is rather a small cup, but it's very nice. And I sort of always try to support the hotel by buying at least a drink, sometimes a meal, when I'm charging at these private hotel establishments, because they've gone out of their way to put in the infrastructure here in their car parks and provide a Tesla supercharging site. Because my Tesla is an old one, it's a 2014, I've got free supercharging on this, so Tesla is paying for my fill up, so I do my little bit and just buy a coffee while I'm waiting at least. If I've got any passengers, we will have a drink. But anyway, just me now, because I've dropped my daughter off and she's gone. So just have a little latte while I'm filling up, and I'll be on my way in a minute. A chap down there who's got a Model Y has just stopped me, and he was charging at this end supercharger here this morning, and he said he was only getting 30 kilowatt. So I've just got back in the car and I'm getting 36 kilowatt charging speed. So it's difficult to tell on these Model S's, these early ones, because they have much slower charging anyway. But he said he was only getting about the same in his Model Y earlier, and he had to move. So I'm going to do the same. I'm getting 36 kilowatt, and my battery is at 56%, so that does seem rather slow. So let's disconnect and move to the next bay. So I've just moved from the end one down to the middle. And now I'm getting 47 kilowatt there. So yes, worth moving. That's going to make quite a difference. Actually, there goes the Model 3 that I was next to. But I would have been caught out there. Anyway, it's dropped to 46 already. But these older Model S's, they do have slower charging, and already I'm at 57%. So on these, they charge much slower than the newer Teslas. These were doing 120, I think, when they were new, but Tesla dropped the charging speeds down with an over-the-air update to prolong the battery life on these older ones. So I think typically I see I would still see a peak of about 110, I think, kilowatt. I don't pay too much notice of it, to be honest, but yeah, I think peak may be still 110, 150 kilowatt, but that's when the battery's very low and not for very long. Most of its charging is at more like 80 kilowatt and then 60 kilowatt and then down to sort of 50 kilowatt like it is now. So that's sort of typical charging, I think. But obviously, like all EVs, as the battery fills up, your charge rate drops. So this standard range Model 3 has just pulled up, and again, he plugged into that same charger at the end, so I jumped out and went and saw him, and his was only charging at 34 kilowatt as well. So he's now moved to this one in the middle, and his is now charging at 170 kilowatt. So if you found this video useful, please do click the thumbs up button, really does help. If you want to know more about electric cars, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you on the next video.